Hi everybody, Joe Hanson here from PBS Digital Studios. It's okay to be smart. I am here on Cannery Row in Monterey Bay, California. You know, it's a tourist town now. Look at all the people here behind me. But it wasn't always like this. We've got a very special surprise location to give you guys a little bit of a history lesson about Monterey Bay, Cannery Row, and just how we got here today to Big Blue Live. First things first, though, you can follow Big Blue Live at hashtag Big Blue Live, and we will be airing Big Blue Live on your local PBS station Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, August 31st, September 1st, September 2nd at 8 p.m. Eastern and Pacific. Let me show you where I am today, though. All right, I'm walking up the stairs of this old building here on Cannery Row. I'm standing in front of the Pacific Biological Laboratories. The ecologist might know the name Ed Ricketts. We're going to step inside and I'm going to show you some real cool stuff. So this is the Pacific Biological Laboratories. This is the home and workshop laboratory, biological supply company of ecologist, father of ecology, Ed Ricketts. We've got some great people from Monterey Bay Aquarium in here, and all of our friends say hi.
Hey, how's it going, Periscope?
And our new friend Frank, who knew the great Ed Ricketts. This is an amazing spot. You want to say hi to the people? Broadcasting live there, Frank. You want to wave to him? Thanks so much. Ed Ricketts was known most famously for writing, I think, this book, Between Pacific Tides. This completely changed the way we look at what's called intertidal ecosystems, which are the kind of place where all those fun creatures like sea anemones and urchins and things, where all the waves are crashing. We're going to keep walking through the house and give you guys a tour. There's a picture of Mr. Ricketts on the wall there. So of course, Monterey is also famous for jazz. We couldn't get by without showing you guys a little picture of that. Look at the people who, little side note, there's a story that we got told here that in this very room and in the backyard here, Louis Armstrong, Miles Davis, all these guys from the Monterey Jazz Festival would show up here and just kind of like hang out and play music late at night. Maybe they talked about biology too. We got some amazing old posters out here. So Monterey Bay wasn't always a tourist town. This used to be a fishing town for the most part. And you know, that street we were out there on is called Cannery Row. And this whole street, before there was an aquarium, before any of the things that we see today, like, you know, places to eat, hotels and stuff like that, this was full of sardine canneries. They would fish sardines out of Monterey Bay. They'd bring them back here, put them in cans. People would eat them and feed them to livestock and use fertilizer and all kinds of things. But that put a big stress on the ecosystem here. And people like Ed Ricketts, working here, collecting specimens, wading through the tide pools and learning how everything was interconnected, kind of revolutionized the way that we look at our relationship with local, with the nature around us. And it's that philosophy that we might not be able, that, you know, looking into a tide pool and seeing all of the organisms that are down there and not quite understand, maybe we don't understand how they're all connected, and we shouldn't assume that we do, and we should do what we can to respect all of the complex interactions and relationships there. You know, we take that kind of idea for granted today, but this was a completely revolutionary idea in the 1940s when people like Ed Ricketts were working. And a lot of that happened right here in this building. This is an incredible, incredible place we've gotten lucky to show you today. I'm gonna flip it around. Amazing posters on the wall. Well, they like to have fun here. We do have a bar included there. You know, like I said, they really love their jazz in here. I'm gonna see if we can get through the window here. We got a live shot of Monterey Bay. We don't call it Big Blue Live for nothing. That's pretty amazing. If anybody has questions about Big Blue Live, that's broadcast, about this historic site they're in, go ahead and keep running in on Periscope and I will answer as many as I can. I'll take you guys out on the porch here. So when Ed Ricketts would, he ran this company out of your Pacific Biological Laboratories, and I'm holding his old catalog, Preserved Zoological Specimens. He would collect these things out of the tide pools here in Monterey Bay and sell them to classrooms, museums, libraries, This is just amazing stuff. I'm gonna open up some of the pages here because I just think the artwork in here is just beautiful. I mean, look at that. They just don't make it like they don't make it like that anymore. So when Ed Ricketts would go out into the bay and collect these specimens that he was gonna ship to museums and classrooms, these are his actual old holding tanks where he would, this is where Ed would keep his specimens, you know, the kind of specimens that change the way that we look at Monterey Bay, and some of the first stuff that saved us from the polluted kind of dead ecosystem that it was. I love the sound of the water too here. I saw that comment come in. This is about the most peaceful place you can imagine working. Ed was a pretty lucky guy. It's come to Monterey Bay, California. Anybody can walk by this. It's right next to the aquarium. It's a really beautiful place. In fact, I might not come home. I'm really enjoying it here. I'll give you guys another little tour of the patio here. I do not know when the jazz festival is coming. That's a great question coming in there. I'm gonna take you guys down the stairs here and we're gonna go underneath to the ground floor and take a look at Ed's original old lab through this door here. So when they bring those specimens in that they were studying, did they lock the door on me? That's really awkward. that's an amazing little spot down there where they would bring those specimens in, pop them in their jars for the catalog here, and send them out to the people to learn all about them. Around here. So a little more history about Cannery Row. You guys hear the seagulls too? That's a great comment that came in. Ed Ricketts had some really famous friends, and he did not work alone. One of the most famous, of course, was John Steinbeck, who wrote the novel Cannery Row, a lot of it in this building, sleeping on Ed Ricketts' couch. Another one was the famous historian, he was a scholar of mythology, Joseph Campbell. He did a lot of the work that the movie Star Wars was based on. So, Star Wars fans, we got a connection here too. Ed's lab is not open to the public when you come into town. We are very lucky to be able to come in here today. You can walk by on the sidewalk and you can see that building. You can take the picture. Somebody wanted to know what it's like to work at PBS. It's the best job in the world. I can't believe I get to come here and not only hang out in this building, but hang out with you guys. This is fantastic. You can look behind me. I mean, this isn't work. I'm not working. Let's be honest. So John Steinbeck's famous book, Cannery Row, was based here. It told the story of a lot of these canneries, canning sardines, but they were catching something like 250,000 tons of sardines out of this bay every year. And you can't just take all of you want of one species out of a place like this and expect there's not going to be some consequences. And it turned out they took too many. The sardines stopped showing up, and this town had some rough years until they decided that they were going to make it about studying nature and appreciating nature and not just taking fish out of the sea, but actually maybe watching fish and learning more about them and all the different marine life that lives around here. The sardine stock question came in. The sardine stock is actually coming back. So, you know, sardines move in these natural cycles, and not only were they taking too many, but sardine populations go up and down naturally with ocean temperatures, different currents, different sources of nutrients. And they have been able to come back. They found a sustainable way to go out to get fish like that out of the bay like this. So I think we're learning how to balance. Over on It's Okay to Be Smart on YouTube and on the PBS Facebook page, I put out a video today telling this whole story about the history. If anybody wants to learn more about all of that, you can head over there onto their Facebook page and watch the whole thing. Is that supporting other species as well? Yes, actually, the sardines are a food source for animals like cormorants, which is a bird, a common bird around here. Everything, sea lions, even humpback whales and blue whales will make these amazing lunging feeding runs into these big balls of sardines. So sardines are a really important part of the ecosystem here too. I'm gonna get my face out of the way and turn around. Isn't that a little more peaceful? All right. So Big Blue Live again is going to be happening Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern and Pacific on your local PBS station.
take one last look at Ed Ricketts' containers there. We're going to head back inside and take another look at the house. We have a lot more periscopes coming your way this week. We're going to have, keep your eyes on the PBS Twitter account. Isn't that an awesome old lamp? I would love to have that on the house. We can't get too close to the water, actually, because it's a historical site, unfortunately. We do have some limitations. There's our friends again. Hi, Monterey Bay.
Hello. Hi, PBS. Hey. Hey, Periscope.
Awesome. All right, and here we are. Periscope's coming up.
Periscope's coming up later this week. We are going to be periscoping live from the aquarium. We're going to have maybe a little sunset chat. We're going to show you guys some more of the beautiful sights and sounds. There's a lot of sounds, a lot of seagulls, a lot of sea lions around here. If I can find an otter, I promise to periscope and show it to you guys. This is... Everybody get a look at that. If you visit Monterey Bay, now you can take a look at the aquarium, but hopefully you'll get a better appreciation for the history and everything that... led to, there's motorcycles too, sorry about that. I hope you guys will get a better appreciation for the history that goes into science. So thank you guys for joining me today on this Periscope. Keep your eyes on the PBS account and we will have lots more coming your way all week, Saturday, Sunday, and some special treats from near the broadcast on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. My name is you can see all of my videos at youtube.com/ It's Okay to Be Smart. My name is Joe Hanson. Thanks for joining me. I will see you all week. And be sure to check out Big Blue Live at the hashtag Big Blue Live. Thanks for joining us, everybody.